How's it going, guys? It's Fisayo here, and right here in the studio is the HP Spectre 13-inch laptop with one of Intel's 10th gen processors. And I think this is one of the fastest compact Windows laptops you can get right now because of its integration with Intel's new development here, but there's more. We'll be talking about Intel and HP in this video, specifically Intel's 10th gen processor and the 13-inch HP Spectre laptop. I get a lot of questions like, hi Fisayo, we need a compact laptop that can work for video editing, for graphic design. For those who follow me, you know I was a graphic designer before and you know it was my full-time job. I know a lot of YouTubers are starting out and want to create something amazing and they need something to start. I'm not saying you should buy this outrightly, but there's some value here, and that's what I want to share with you guys. If you want to skip ahead to different sections of this video for quick information, please check the description below for the timestamps for each of the chapters of this video. Without further ado, let's get to it. Some key specifications to note here for my model are the 8 gigs of RAM, and you can move up to 16 gigs of RAM. You also get 500 gigabytes of SSD, which I've seen configured to up to 2 terabytes of SSD. Also, you got 32 gigabytes of Optane memory for that extra boost in performance in general. I was able to do some light gaming on here, and I did find that the Spectre here has 1 gigabyte of video RAM separate from the 8 gigs of actual RAM. Shout out to the new Intel Plus graphics. It was able to take games like Asphalt 9 Legends, while other games like Call of Duty and Gears of War had higher requirements. So if you want to get this for gaming, I suggest you go with the higher graphics or higher video memory option. You can experience gaming on the normal desktop mode with your keyboards, or if you want the full tablet experience, you can do that with the gyroscope and tilt your laptop or tablet. And I thought it was a cool experience, really. I didn't notice any lags here. Shout out to the processors on this guy. Now let's take a deeper look into the processor. What is it about the Intel 10th gen processor that makes this thing tick? Intel has and is a major household name in computing, especially when it comes to processors. If you're my age or maybe older, or you know a lot about computers, you will definitely remember the days of the introduction of Intel Pentium, which was extensively redefined. And now onto the Core series, you're probably familiar with your Core i3, Core Duo, Core i5, Core i7, and Core i9. Obviously, in terms of progressions, as you can see here, there are key benefits to upgrading, especially with the 10th generation processors, where you get better graphics, you get better ability to do heavy photo work, heavy video work, and of course, the higher price tag when you upgrade. That's sort of a brief look. Some key features of Intel's 10th gen processors you should note are Wi-Fi 6 gig plus for gamers to enjoy better speeds while gaming, of course alongside low latency or lags, and protection against Wi-Fi hacking. When I tested gaming on this laptop, it was smooth. Another feature it supports is better frame rate, so your gaming is definitely much more immersive. To enjoy the maximum benefit, you could also consider investing in something like a PC build and using their Core i9 10th gen processors or a higher end laptop. You've also got Thunderbolt 3 ports, which provide more bandwidth and more speed. It's much better than USB 3.0. And when I transferred files, like transferred my videos that I shot from my memory card onto this laptop, it was actually quite fast. I previously mentioned Intel Optane memory and of course their newest SSD technology. That way, when your transfer speeds are faster, your video editing software can benefit from this. I used this laptop to edit a video as well and it was quite responsive. I didn't have any playback issues for full HD videos, nothing like skipped frames or anything of the sort. For the power users, there's an option for overclocking up to 3.9 GHz. And in fact, if you get the Core i9 10th gen Intel processors, it lets you go crazy with overclocking and you can get up to like 5.3 gigahertz. That's just too much. Anyway, I think Intel's 10th gen processors are definitely a good move from Intel. And for them, it's a good way, at least on this HP Spectre, the 13-inch version here, to get desktop level performance combined with the feeling of a tablet into one device. I think light gamers would benefit since most mainstream video editing softwares require at least 8 gigs of RAM. You've got that here and you've also got an SSD as well. It's thin and it's light and it's highly suited for those who want to do a lot of word processing, browsing and light gaming here and there. I'll leave details for the price tag and where to get the HP Spectre for the best price in the description below. As far as price to quality ratio, I think it's value that you're paying for on here. Also guys, if you made it this far in the video, I'd appreciate it if you could like this video and consider subscribing to the channel and hitting the bell icon beside it, so you'll be the first to know when I post a new video. All right, back to the Spectre. With me here, I've got the Core i7 version of the HP Spectre x360. It's got approximately 13 inches, 13.2 inches to be exact in screen size. It's a full HD touchscreen display. I found the display to be really good. The touch was really responsive and, you know, there are bezels quite all right, but you know, it's not all to the sides, it's just at the bottom area and I don't really mind that much. You've also got auto rotate. When you turn this into a sort of canopy mode, it flips the entire display as well. One of the very interesting things about this laptop is that it does flip onto the other side, hence the X360 in the name. The flip mode is straightforward and it turns to the back of the laptop, making it a tablet. In fact, the precisely cut edges are so well thought out that if there is a charger or USB-C cable plugged in, it will not be affected. It's just a cool touch to the design. However, the keyboard sticking out to the back is a design choice I wish could have been better. But hey, it works, and if you buy it, you do get a stylus. I think the design overall is appealing. Speaking of the design, when it comes to the ports and I/O, first of all, on the right side of the laptop is where we get the micro SD card slot, the camera switch to turn on and off the camera, which is very good for privacy, the USB-C port, the charging indicator, and another USB-C port, which is adjacent in an adjacent angle. On the left side, we've got the USB-A port, and it's cool that it managed to fit a USB port, a full-size USB port, into the slimness of your laptop here. To access it, you just need to flip it down a little bit. To the left of it is also the headphone jack, and lastly, in the corner is where you've got the power button. And I must say that if I didn't check the manual, I probably wouldn't know that there was a power button on this laptop. I actually searched for it. Yeah. I did. Anyway, you've got the HP logo up top, and on the back is where you've got your vents and your speakers as well. There's also the grip, and this laptop does feel sturdy and light at the same time in my hands. You've also got the fingerprint sensor, and in addition you get a face scanner to unlock your laptop. There's quite a few Spectre brandings on here, and speaking of branding, the speakers are made by Bang & Olufsen. The front facing camera is also pretty good, so webcam images for video conferences or video calls, Skype, Zoom, etc. will just work fine. My typing experience was really great on the Spectre. I thought the key travel was just right and the tactile feedback on it was very welcome. It's controllably backlit in three different modes, which is completely off, turned on, or at medium brightness. Another privacy tool you have on the keyboard is the ability to turn off your mic as well, and it shows an orange light so you know that your mic is muted. Also good for privacy. However, because of the small form factor of this 13-inch laptop, if you've got bigger hands, you have the option of purchasing the 13-inch or the 15-inch, depending on your preference. If you can go to the store to test out this laptop before you buy it, you should. The trackpad is slightly smaller, but I was used to it. In fact, it didn't hold me back as much because I had a mouse as a substitute. Also, my day-to-day use was fine without any complaints. It loaded tasks quickly, multitasking was on point, always on point, and overall it was an enjoyable experience. Battery life was fair for me because of my light workload, and in my testing of the Spectre, I only had the battery to be low about 2 or 3 times, and it runs well for like 5 to 8 hours depending on your level of usage if you don't turn on all the sensors like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, and you know, I turned that on a lot. I also like that the charger that it comes with, although it was compact, it was a threaded cable, which is just a very nice touch, and it has a clip to hold the cable in place. Question of the day, what's your favorite feature of the Intel Optane processors on this HP Spectre? If you had all the money in the world, would you get this? Also guys, maybe if for some reason you got to buy any HP laptop with Intel's 10th gen processors, make sure you look for the 10th gen processors, by the way. Please let me know what store it was, maybe on Instagram or Twitter. If you're shy, you can send me a DM. My handles are displayed right here. And if you found this video useful, please drop a like and drop a comment below if you have any questions. If you think there's anything I missed, let me know in the comments there. Let's chat there. I'm sure to answer you guys as soon as possible. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. You might need restraint. Especially with the 10th. Yeah. If you guys watch my video, you probably get the restraint joke. But yeah, anyway. Especially with the 10th gen.
Generator.
Generation.